Oh, the artillery brush missing, actually. That's a pretty big deal. And now artillery kind of exposing himself right there. Tempest coming in the meantime. Rowland, the parasite gets a kind of gun engineer. No way to defeat him. But a big Tempest ultimate coming out right there. I missed SDY falling to pieces. And Stay Green gonna continue this push now. Parasite in the background. He's already done his job. Will he survive in the end? No, he will not. He gets picked up. Wild Soul gets rotten grass. And Stay Green going full force right here. They're gonna go for the genocide. And the genocide Stay Green will get. Talk about coming to the real.
They're really just trying to do the job of holding down.
Oh, there we go. Another line shot in the background. Down to the foreground. Artillery get barrage. They're going to be going up. Dewa being turned on. Torture holding his ground against Rally in the meantime. The Shrunkenhead is up. He is going to be mitigating the damage. Look at the energy field placement, by the way. A great block out right there. Down goes Rally in the background. Big Parasite Burst, though, on to Jesse. No Tempest ultimate from him. Warby's in that Metamorphosis form, but Wild Soul chasing. And now Stay Green's on the run. Actually, Torture main hero block. He will fall with Engineer. Big hold there from SS2Y.
Oh, the win. Can you run over,
Fred? Okay, run away.
I got one.
I'm smashing.
Okay.
Wait,
I'm
smashing.
I'm coming.
Smashing! Fucking go!
Yeah, I'm smashing!
I got one. Oh, he's dead. Nice.
What's up, baby? It's shit.
So we do see Capel coming out from Rally. He's got some good distance, however. And now here comes Monkey King. Ampat jumps inside Monkey King. They're going to look to be the Wrecking Crew right here. Tempest being bounced back and forth. He's in trouble. Or is he? The Elemental Void coming out right there. Rally sitting in the back and will finally come through with the stun. It was fairly late, though. They do get the kill on the Tempest. And Monkey King, he is still well alive, baby. He's doing plenty of damage. Champion of New Earth is Monkey King. 10-1-4. He wants more kill damage.
He's got himself, but realizes he can't do enough damage here.
Look at Pebbles like here. Here he comes. Look at that. Look at Alona just absolutely mailed right off the bat. Tempest going to be the next
Jeremy
choice. He's going in.
Well,
Kichiro comes out. The Hellfire Supply. Oh, the Codex to finish him off. Will he make it a 1v3? Taking the mold out. Xamarin's going to use the Desert's Curse. The One Gym Slam. The Heavenly Bolt. Oh, he pushes him over the other side of the ledge. He's kind of stuck on there. Pebbles jumps in. And yes!
Look out!
He gets the
hat trick. 900 gold per minute.
Oh, my God. 900 gold per minute. Yeah, just pretty confident they can make something happen. Actually, jumping to Master Bars right there. Oh, the Tempest ultimate will pull him in. It's not going to be stopped in time, or will it be? It is stopped. Master Bars eventually does fall out. However, here's the response out from Complexity. Crew comes out. Big burst damage on the Tempest right there. But again, he's already done his job to an extent. Predator now leaping in. He gets one kill. He gets two kills. And Axe is feeling pretty good after that. Oh, look at that. Pyromancer gets jumped by Bubbles. Oh, he gets the shut off. But Predator leaps in and gets a quick kill. In the meantime, Pebbles jumps on the Pandemonium. Pandemonium being on the double damage. Predator doing so much damage. He's going to be rooted down right there. Does he have a Stonehead? He's actually not using it just yet. He's still being locked in. He finally gets out of it. Look at Keeper of the Forest locked up by the Elemental Void. He will be destroyed. GG's being called. And that's going to do it for Complexity versus Stay Greedy.
Forward.
Oh my god! Stun up. There comes the Master of Arts ball up the lava surge on top of that. The chain reactions does come out. Will it be enough to save Gemini? No, it will not. Gemini goes in right there. Support gets credit for the kill. But a huge shot. What a wall off from Empath coming out in the meantime. But DC Torch are going to cut through the trees, however. Trying to get away. The chase is still on. However, Rally has another compel.
No,
not the mana, though. But Torture is still going to fall. Wow, a big start for BDT, 2-0.
No, don't get thrown in.
They're going to go right for Empath, and down goes Empath. One hit wonder right there. Off of the message call, going to be used on a Gemini. The counter stun onto Devil right there, coming up from Rally. Here comes the first potential from Gemini now. But no, there's a big eruption though from Nimbus coming up. Down one fall. Holy crap, stage great is all falling apart. Torture trying to stay alive as long as he can, but it's not going to be long enough. 4-for-1 exchange in favor of Vietnamese Dream Team. Right now, as it usually is, they're going to send another Torture right here. Twin Face has a land, but it doesn't matter. Their Twin Breath's going to be done up right there. Deadwood's in trouble. The eruption in the back end, it's going to be stopped by Kegstown, but down goes
Deadwood.
Back
on Deadwood. They're going
free. Just can't come out flat. Like, I know we think we're better than they are, and we are, but we cannot start a game and just, like, be
go 0-8, yeah.
Just, no, it's not even that. It's just the attitude we brought into the game is that it was a free win, and no game is a free win. We only lose is the streak. We're still winning the slam. Don't worry about it. Hold your heads up. You get a nice, good sleep, and we cut call tomorrow. It's no biggie. Just remember, like, this is what happened when we lost to fucking Afraid, and then we were like, hey, guys, no team is a free win. We came back, and we didn't lose until now. Just gonna repeat. Same shit. Good shit. It's no worries. Keep your heads up.
Yeah, it's all good.
Go, Magmus stuns it right there. The part though, the Aluna stun. No, not gonna come out. Parmenter stuns Tempest first, actually. There's the Aluna stun. There's the Glacial Blast. And Swinemouth is very likely gonna fall. Will he be able to get away? No, the Lava Surge comes out and Bloodlust kill in favor of Complexity.
Your point is potential. Let's take me back out here.
There we go. Community Quest gonna be jumped. I can't get the root off in time. The stun locks just a little bit too much. There's the counter though on the Rally. There's the root coming up. But the Elemental Void from Riser. Predator leaps in. Down goes Keeper of the Forest. Pebble's already used all his load right there. He's completely out of mana now. Predator's gonna sit on top of him. There's the compel, and Pebbles will end up falling. Pyromancer
the Rally buyback.
But Rally does buy back, and now they're gonna look to set up a kill on a Z-Freak as well. I did not see Z-Freak getting out of this one. Another compel gonna be coming up in 3 seconds right here.
He gets out of this one, I will hail him as my new god.
There's a demoralizing roar. Rally's down here. Luna comes in with Elisa. The port's coming in for Seagate. They want to try to capitalize on a turn here. But at what cost? Magma starts in. Elisa on to both Keeper's Pebbles. There's the initiated. The seismic slam. And
are you kidding
fall
me?
Ultimate
elemental void
case.
Use. Not even
not
necessary.
Even necessary, though. But here's the reaction. Rally going to Parmenter. Pebbles fall right off the path. They do not have buybacks. That could have been the game right there. Double tap coming out. Keeper the force balls. GG well plays. Complexity takes out. Stay green here at the group stages.
Oh, he's actually getting the body block here.
Yeah,
has the boots. Russian Hag has the boots. The double boots combination.
The chain reactions aren't going to hit. Will it be enough for the getaway? Probably. No, he gets pushed
over. Oh, the kill. It doesn't even save him.
Mark Rowley gets gone up with a face hug, but he's able to reaction time. And actually, they could get a counter kill on this. Compelled to the inflation. He got chain reactions, though. Income flow, so the head smash. Rally's dropping quickly. The haste, though, gotta keep him alive. Artillery barrage, the other arm comes out. And now Losen and Parasite. There, the ones that need to be on the run. Chain reactions and hits both right there. Aluna running on the uphill to give the vision, if anything. The bunker down gonna be used. But here comes a bad blast from Regidag. Lowstone will fall. There's a son of scream. Regidag doing some cleanup duty right here.
Off to the side.
Peely, oh, what a chuck right there from Limp. Double tap come out from Hatchet and Limp. SGEU. Aluna, that's going to be a dead Aluna. However, a warranty, will they jump themselves? Yes, they jump over here. Glacial Dam, we're going to be stopped. Eruption, B channel, I'm not going to go off though. Magnus gets silenced by the face hug. The Bat Blast is going to be used, and he will fall. They get the go to Glacius, but at what cost right here? Rally's now trying to run away, as well as Torture. It's just them fighting against the team of SGEU. Torture goes down, and Rally just has to walk away with that haste through Haxor and picks up. Here we go. Barrow jumps in. Big Mimo right there. Sets
the
up
Barrow. Activated.
Bubbles got their Barrow drivers up. And Moquist now on the run. Sandwich joining the party. Sandwich in the front lines. Her teammates
look
are dead
low
though.
Congor
with
is.
Bubbles and
he's got to get.
Congor is very low. Barrow is going to fall right here.
Can't do it. There's too much lockdown.
This is Chris for 1 second. He's going to go for it. No, it's picked up by Moon Queen. She's going to try right off the bat, though. Can they lock her down? Tempest has an ultimate to use to help. Moon Queen in the back, and that Moonbeam comes out. Again, has the ultimate. Not going to choose to use it, though. Just would not have the support.
He kills the Witch Slayer.
Oh, Sam Ray's ultimate right here. Where is the real one in the background? Going straight for Witch Slayer. Once again, they're locking it down. Pharaoh comes in a big moment wall. Going to trap several heals. The Tempest ultimate right on top of it. The follow-up for Pyromancer. The burst damage on Ophelia gets the Ophelia's touch on time. The Feriado comes up. The Moon Finale comes off. Slex trying to do it for his team right here. Will it be enough in the end? The chase is out a little in the background. It's Sarah versus Moon Queen. Sarah versus Moon Queen. Bubbles here as well. Gets the kill on a Moon Queen.
He just picked up his shrunken head. This is a crucial moment. No buyback.
No, he's
That is the worst timing imaginable. That is absolutely the worst.
This ward has to do with the token after. There we go. That's the jump. Cole coming up. Pavos with the reaction. That tap is all they're going to go off, though. He is going to get the full duration. It looks like Draconis will end up falling from Master of Arms with tons of damage in the background, actually. But here comes Draconis. Cataclysm gets on as soon as he comes back out. A pretty good spread from Stay Green, honestly. But the melee Rax is falling. Haxorin going to finish it off. He's trying. It's not going to be finished just yet. Going back in. The melee Rax will fall. There's the Blazing Flight to look to get away. Master of Arms be locked down. Warby's also be locked down. He does not have the ultimate form. He had a shark in head, but couldn't get it off in time. He ends up dropping. Draconis is going to get caught. Tempest with the wall, of course, no element of void. He turns around. Cataclysm can saw going up right there, but he's taking a lot of damage. Draconis is going to fall in the background. Warby's still chasing. Warby's is somewhat dropping despite that shark in head. He's going to barely stay alive, though. Yes, he's going to live in the end. No, he falls in the end. Kelpfield was used, trapping several players in place. But Stay Green is pushing back SGEU. Bubble's going to use that takeover. He will not be able to port away.
This is where it gets real. Not only did he get the token,
wow.
We saw Doombringer picked up in this moment of desperation.
Wow. Oh, there we go. The jump onto Draconis. The one Tempest Ultimate. It's going to go full duration. He has another one to go. The second Tempest Ultimate. And Stay Green probably just pulled the comeback of the tournament right there. Unbelievable. Pebbles is going to jump in right here. Stay Green EU trying to make a response.
They still have token up. They still have bananas
up. Pebbles is dead. Bubbles is going to fall here. Draconis, Cataclysmic Assault. He's trying to hold the cannon. He falls. Stay Green again in such good spot right here. Is this going to be the game? Master of Arms
I think they just took the tournament back.
There goes Pebbles falling quickly. Talbot's away. He is going to be picked up. Like in the end, Bubbles trying to maybe do something. He goes down.
No one can buy back. That's going to be the throne.
Game number
one. Oh my God.
Coming in right here. Will hit Bubbles. A size of time. Not going to go off though. Take cover. Avoid the Bat Blast. Bubbles is still alive in the background. Using the shelter support. And down goes Ratchet. The Moon Finale doing some good damage right here. Stay Green committing pretty damn far. Will it pay off in the end? Tempest will fall before he can get the elemental one off.
Moon Finale is
coming out. The Seismic Slam. It does connect. Go right there, but at what cost right here? Rally jumps in, Mookie driving. The Seismic Slam not able to go off. He splits up with the Jammer Spin. Gets the Moon Finale off, but he falls in the process. He will buy back immediately, but will it matter when it's all said and done? Warby's with that Shrunken Head activated. It's tearing Bevel. People up left and right. Gets the melee racks, gets the ranged racks. There is the vote to concede. Stay Green will take out SGEU. 2-0 here. The pole, it does go off for that. Shrunken Head goes off though. The Magma's gonna chill off the rush and the Root comes out. There's the stun and though with the eruption. Berserker still in the midst of it though. He is still alive. The Carnage again activated. The Strength Zap is up. Going for Parasite. Takes over the creep. Gonna be fine for now. The Kite, will it be enough in the end? Berserker chasing. The Mark for Death, but the stun comes out. But again with the Carnage. Look at the freaking Carnage. Down goes Magma's. Pee-wee's going to survive. Running away, he finally will fall to Wretched Hag right there. This is where the Kite comes into play. Look at it. Berserker just basically walking around at this point. 3 more seconds. Mark for Death up at 2. There's the stun. He will have Carnage now. He cannot get it off in time. The Carnage not up just yet. He's still chasing. Health bars applied. Can he actually get it off? No, he cannot. He's constantly being silenced this whole time. And Pee-wee will fall in the end.
There's the
compelled in. Master of Arms, in comes the Gemini Sun as well. Reptron being channeled to the back. Master may fall right here. Yes, he will, but again, he has a circle of life. Going to come right back up. The Reptron went off, but now Magus is going to fall.
They're still at full health. Then after pretty much a full channeled Magus ulti, they're getting cleaned up from here.
The initial burst on Master was nice, but yeah, exactly. The follow-up damage, the consistent damage just not there. They are going to try to hold this off a little bit longer. Gemini coming back in. The double stun with his
minion. Silence coming out from Bubbles, too, man.
Yeah.
Locking him down. Pain to the giant. There's the concede mode. Complexity's taken. Worry for everyone going to be coming in here.
Here we go. Can they kill Rally before they all get in? Yes, they can. Battle's coming. The elemental void connects on the two of them that also join the party. The red set on top of that. Give the force still trying to root. Will he get off? Yona! Yes, he will right there after the Kelfield initial stun. Boom goes to Enderman and Wretched. I couldn't be able to blink away in time, though. Surviving for now in the background. Trying to finish off Bubbles. Can't finish off Bubbles, though. And Bubbles will stay alive in the end. The chase on a beacon. Pebble's going to go down. Jumping in. Oh, the nice trigger down by Wretched. Actually, perfect timing on his part. And now Rally's
out there.
The other one going to be pushed out immediately, though. Will be stopped. Kelfield going to be used. Rally doesn't have falling in the midst of it all. Sorry for taking a lot of damage. There's a restoration cell. The double root coming out. Pebble's just standing there. Not much else that he can do. He will eventually fall. Wretched goes out of the background. Electrician, it seems like he may get away. Oh man, is he tanky enough? I think he just might be, actually. The Moonator will survive, but you know, Sage Green, not really too concerned about that. They're gonna... Daddy once again. Damn it, does have an elemental void. Can't get it off. Gonna be purged right there. There's the elemental void. It's gonna be a full duration. And Stake, you're gonna collapse on top of Complexity. Will it be enough for the kill, though? Compelled off for Rally right there. Tablet, I should say. But they will all fall when it's all said and done. Keeper of the Force, he's gonna be dusted. He will go down too. Buybacks are happening, by the way. It looks like at least. Yeah, Gauntlet comes back in. Predator's still dead. The grapple's gonna miss right there.
Deja Vu!
Can she get away?
The slow coming on out.
Coming back in, static grip on
double,
a right there.
Double compel.
It will get the kill.
Nope.
Z-Freak is still alive somehow. Not for long though. Smash in the face and he will finally diminish.
If it hits though.
Pebbles are going right for Glacius. One auto attack later. He gets felled. We jump on a Tempest to Predator, but he takes the Falcon Punch. He has the Stone Knight out. But there's the Elemental Void. The root comes out. The second Elemental Void. Is it going to go off? No, not yet. He gets locked down actually. Jesse will fall. And does Complexity have enough? I don't think they do, honestly. Gauntlet is going to go down. Predator is
Rally's
dead. He's
back
not
up,
buying
but what
back.
Will it even
Rally
do
just
in the end?
Locked down immediately. And I believe we
that should
seen
be the last fight.
Can he actually get away? No, Tablet's not going to be up just yet, but he gets that chance to point that he's looking for. Look at Pebbles coming in to claim them. Moon Finale going to be used right there, but Bubbles is still alive. The Skulls and Net auto hacks are in. In comes the Mickey Mouse, Seismic Sam, Peter Pan Dam. Can he fall? Yes, Peter Pan Dam will fall, but at what cost right here? Rally's trying to run away right now. The auto attacks are going to be enough to finish him off. Moon Queen hanging around, and she goes down. GG well played. Game number one is going to go to Complexity here. Rally compelled, misses though. Pebbles goes in first. Demented Shaman gonna drop in the background. Kelfu gonna be coming out. Torture activating all the his abilities. The family gonna be going off right there. Retroduct chasing him. In comes Bubbles from behind. Giving the force. Root going off. Nymphor. Zeal Stunt coming out right here. Zephyr in the midst of it all. The Typhoon is down. He's gonna have to run away though. The energy field trying to do work, but not enough to scare off Complexity. Double tap for Riser. And Haxor is gonna fall back to base. Complexity. Or will he? No, he won't. GG well plays. The game is over just like that. Complexity takes the game, they take the series, and Complexity is going to the grand finals to take on Stay Green.
We're getting a lucky first hit root.
Wow, the first hit and take on the Hong Kong to his favorite right there. Slick's gonna be locked up in the Kelfin though. Bubbles jumps in, but now he's in trouble. There's their Glacial Tapper off the side. The Tempest Ultimate, all they're gonna pull the Glacius really. The healing touch, keep it alive initially. He will finally fall though. A 2-for-0 exchange right there so far.
They're gonna be surrounded.
Oh, for Witch Slayer, or they're going for Wild Soul actually. I don't know about that. Wild Soul, damn tanky. Oh man, this could be a disaster for Witch Slayer. He's gonna get a tangle. There's a Pap Blast. I don't get it. Kill the bear right here. But at what cost? Here's the follow up. The Pebble's coming up. Pebble scores being the Tempest on the mid of the back. And it is going to be a full duration. Skeleton King coming over, but it's not going to be netted in time.
No buyback for Bubbles.
Looking bad right here. Bubbles is dead. Not buying back, as you mentioned. Pebbles did. But it's probably not going to matter. Stay gray. The power's just too much.
Just about midnight. I cannot believe this arena is full. Are you all Han fans? All right, we're getting somewhere. Well, we are at the DreamHack Summer 2013 Heroes of New Earth Championship. We've already played one game of the finals, and Stay Green is one game ahead. Complexity has a chance to take it back, or Stay Green could take everything. Let's get these games underway, and please help me welcome the teams. First up, we have Complexity. Playing support for Complexity, we have Peter Pandam. On jungle, we have Riser. Playing suicide, Moon Meander. Harry is last year's caster, Tropomador. And the mid player and captain, B-Kid. Now it's time to welcome their opponents. Up by one game, it's Team Stay Green. Playing support, Z-Freak. His jungler, Chessy. Keizu on suicide. Playing carry, it's Slick. And rounding out the team, please welcome Swindle Melons. Our gamers are in place, they're ready to play. Time to hand it off to our excellent casters, Frankie CPK and Emperor.
From this, the chase is on.
Coming around.
Surf does hit. Starting to see. There's the Kelpo coming out on Electrician as well. He's going to do a ring around the freaking Rosie, trying to kite them away. He finally tries to rob a Bloodlust kill. Comes out in favor. Riser right there. Torture
tries to
attack. And Z-Freak is going to fall as well. Man, they really want to kill it. In the meantime, Bubbles goes in with the Starting to see. Pebbles will jump in a quick kill on the Glacier right there. But Magnus comes in the rush.
Chessy
going
to fall dead.
Right off the bat. So no elemental point for him. Seismic Slam. It only hits Boo Boo. It did not hit Wild Soul. And Swindle Melons is going to be locked down on top of that. Complexity looking very strong right now in this fight. Torture's in some trouble. Z-Freak will fall. And Complexity, will they chase? Will they fall back? Maybe try to continue Congor here. Complexity not fully there. She's just going to be used on Pebbles. And now Slick's in some trouble. Slap's going to help it a little bit right there. Takes the Lava Surge. The Amplified Damage comes out. Here comes the Chessy Ultimate. Not going to be enough, though. Tempest Ultimate immediately canceled. Glacial Downpour off to the side. Tempest probably going to fall in the background. And Boo Boo continuing to do so much work. Magnus helping chase him down. Electrician just going to walk away. GG, well played. We are going to a game number three, ladies and gentlemen. Complexity and Stay Green. Doing what he did before. He doesn't have the silver bullet just yet, but they're going to go in on a Feral, but maybe he's having a little bit too much. Or did he? Pyromancer comes in. The save on a Feral of the Mana Battery. The Deep of the Master Skull. Down goes Witch Surf. Chessy's on the run. He's going to go down as well. We do see Pyromancer now. He's going to try to run away. But the Gauntlet, he grapples right there. What did he grapple? The Water Rev put down. There's the auto attack, but Pebbles, I think, it might just be outside of the range of the Rev, so he didn't even know he was there, and he ends up grappling him. Pyromancer is going to fall. The Ophelia's touch gonna be his barrel in no man land in the background. Demon the Master Skull on himself. Orbis being locked down. The Tempest Ultimate wasn't even used right there.
It was canceled
immediately. And now he's trying to back up. Nobody dead yet. How is nobody freaking dead here? Unbelievable.
So they're attempting to run the power shot, potentially gonna stop it.
Doesn't have the mana to blink out,
and the follow-up from Gauntlet bringing him down. So amidst all that chaos, ultimate's being used. A Pharaoh Hook. Elemental Void canceled right away. No
doing?
Blazing Strikes, though.
He's still going back in. The board is coming in. Okay, so the buyback. Happening right here on Juice Windham. Oh, he's going to jump back in a big slide by sending three arrows in the tunnel. The Mummy Wall is going to come up as well from Pharaoh, but down goes the Luna in the background. The Mummy Wall going to block off the rest of the game for a little bit. And if anything, Mumian is going to distract him as long as possible. So this will be two kills here. Four stay green, but Mummy Wall going in once again. But this Mummy Wall misses. It was blocking them off, though. And that is why Kongor is successful. He gets that swag man.
The Storm Spirit coming out.
Gonna save that Tempest Ultimate. Gonna pull him in. And Master of Arms actually joins him as well. Down goes Barrel. Master of Arms batting in the auto attacks. In comes Gauntlet. Tempest will fall. He already elemental point though, so definitely not the biggest deal in the world. Master of Arms comes back on the center line. And Trap him and Arm will go down. Complexity is starting to fall apart right here. Stay Green winning the fight. Double tap coming up for Kesu. You look at Warby's in the front lines going nom nom nom. There goes Pebbles on the Master of Arms. The Storm Spirit coming out. Tempest Ultimate in the background though. It's going to be a full lockdown. Master of Arms will fall. Stay Green looking good once again. The Mummy Walls go up. Down goes Gala right there. Down goes Pharaoh. And did Stay Green just really do it right there? They're going to chase down Aluna. She was trying to run away with a Deja Vu. Going to get miniaturized however. And Peter Pan Dam will also be picked off in the end. A double tap for
Slicks. Two fights in a row. They didn't take a single death. Congratulations, Team Stay Green.
There you go. You see right there, Stay Green, understandably happy, of course. Music loud, the fans cheering. Again, very, very deserving. They were the big dogs coming into the event. They had the slump. They lost the three games in a row. BDT, Complexity, and Stay KDU only defeating them. They did not let that phase them. They're down an immense amount. One of the greatest comebacks we've ever seen in the first round of the winning bracket there against Stay KDU. And, you know, what better team to win really in the end, right? So,
your DreamHack Summer Champions, Stay Green and Complexity. Let's give it up for both of them. We fucking killed it! Woo!